Hey, moms and dads, it's Dr. Scott. Hey, I just want to take a moment here. I just want to tell you a really cool story that we've seen with one of our patients here over the last week and a half. So, we get a lot of kids who come in with issues varying from ADHD to sensory processing issues. One of the ones that obviously is the most difficult for families is oppositional defiance disorder. And if this is something you're dealing with your own child, then obviously you know how damaging this can be to your family. And so one of the little guys that we have here in practice, he was dealing with some pretty significant issues with this. His mom and his dad and his siblings were literally living in fear of this poor little guy. And he's literally just a toddler. And so when he would have any little thing set him off, I mean, he would go into attacks where he would bite, kick, scrape, scream. I mean, everything would set him off so that the entire family literally was just living on the edge with this guy. And if this is your child, do me a favor. I want you to go and hit a like and let me know that this is what you're going through, because this is going to be very relevant for you. So as you know how difficult this can be to try and deal with and manage, and you know how to handle them, let alone how to calm them down, I want to give you just a quick little, I guess, a testimonial or a story about this little guy, because he's been a patient here in our office now for, I think, 5.5 weeks. And so thank you very much for the like there. And so this little dude, when he first came in, I mean, you know, his scans that we perform show that his nervous system is completely dominant to the fight or flight side. And so for those of you who don't know how the brain manages the body, there's the two divisions, the fight or flight and the rest and digest division. When a child has severe oppositional defiant disorder, their fight or flight nervous system is literally kicked on to the maximum. It means that every single thing that comes into their brain is being perceived as a threat. And so that literally means that if a child has something that seems trivial, right, like a sibling accidentally bumps them, they can go off on a tangent, be completely violent, on complete defensive mode, and even attack them for things that would be seemingly trivial. Because their brain is not perceiving threats appropriately, right? Our brains are supposed to literally go through this loop where we receive a stimulus, the brain perceives, is it a threat, is it not a threat, and then decides an appropriate reaction. When a kid's ODD, it doesn't happen like that. It literally goes into maximum defensive posture. So let me get back into the story here. So this little guy, when he started care, we put him on a care plan that goal number one was just to get his brain to turn the page. And I was telling the mom, what we need to do is we need to literally build a gap, right? When he started, there was no gap from his stress response to logic. He should be able to go and have this space where stressor comes in and he's able to perceive it, decide how to respond appropriately instead of going straight into stress mode. So we began on a care plan, and about 5 weeks now he's been in care, or excuse me, 5.5 weeks now. And mom reported that about 2 weeks ago, he started to really turn a major corner. So she started reporting that not only was he not becoming aggressive against them, but he was actually becoming sweet. Like, he used to never come in when his dad would come home from work, he would never come over to him and give him a kiss. Like, he was the little dude who was just constantly on the defensive. And so now what he's been doing is he comes in and he will go and hug his dad, give him a kiss. He'll go and cuddle with his mom for the first time. He will go and spend time with his brother and they won't fight. First time ever that that's happened. But they're showing all these positive changes because for the first time, literally in his entire life, this little guy is experiencing something other than a stress input. And so, you know, obviously if this is something you're living with, I bet you can relate to how nice this would be if your family could be going through this kind of a change, right? Because I can imagine how terrible it is to live with something like this. But they're starting to see this little guy change. But the most important thing is that it's not a temporary change. Because if you talk about cause, right, cause is his nervous system got turned on to fight or flight. And in his particular case, it was the birth process, right? He had a really traumatic birth, very difficult labor and delivery. And because of a mechanical stressor that was in place, because he had a C-section delivery, his little nervous system was never able to come out of fight or flight, because his brain, when he had this process from the C-section, the mechanical stresses just put it into maximum fight or flight and it never came down. So now for the first time in his life, he's experiencing the opposite side. And so what'll happen is each time that we give him an adjustment, right, what we're doing is we're literally tapping the brake pedal to his brain. So he's starting to have a gap from the stress response to a normal response. And now what we do is we build momentum. The process of literally building the gap is all about taking his input of the stress and allowing his brain to just have time to go through a loop instead of going up into the stress and anxiety center of the brain called the amygdala. The cortex is where he's supposed to perceive all this stuff. And so when we're giving his brain a chance to have that loop occur, what they're starting to see as the output is better regulation of his emotions, but more importantly, better perception of stress and threat versus normal. So if this is your child and this is something you're going through, my heart goes out to you. But I want to let you know there's hope. That's the most important thing. And let me tell you something. I see this every day. This isn't an unexpected outcome. This is an expected outcome with the kids that we treat. Because when you look at oppositional defiance issues, right? You can classify, you can call it whatever you want. You can put labels on it, you can give meds to it. But the root cause to it is if a nervous system can't calm itself down, then it only has a couple of choices. When a stress response is wired on, the brain can't turn it off by itself without help in some cases. In this little guy's case, his brain was so wired into fight or flight, he went down the road of aggression, but it can turn into ADHD. It can turn into sensory processing issues. It can be anxiety, it can be depression, it can be all kinds of different things based upon how severely the nervous system gets stressed. So I want to let you know that if this is something that you have questions about, there's a lot of help out there. Shoot me messages. I'll gladly go and point you in the right direction to doctors that can help you. If you have questions for me directly, more than happy to help. But make sure that you're getting the help that you need. If you need a provider near you and you're not in my area, go to www.thenwf.org, and there's a provider directory of people that are all over the country. So if you're in my region here and you want to talk to us directly, I'm more than happy to go and take some time aside to sit and talk to you about your child so we can discuss what's going on. Our address here for the website is www.elitehealthandwellness.net. Be more than happy to help you answer questions. Let me know what we can do. Okay, this is Dr. Scott. God bless you guys. Be elite.